MrExcel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from MrExcel, episode 1343, Compare Sheets, part 2. Hey, in yesterday's netcast, I had a question from James. James had these two different sheets, United States and Denmark, and he wanted to compare the values on the two sheets. And yesterday I just did compare side by side. Probably it's not going to work most of the time because the rows are going to be out of sequence or something like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually do a Vlookup to get this data from one side to the other. First thing I want to do is I need to get rid of the merge cells. Select all cells and then Control 1, go to alignment, and you see merge cells here is it's neither checked nor unchecked. It's in this tri-state, the kind of mixed state. So one, two clicks, we'll get it back to unmerged. And then, let's see up here, we're going to add above all of these cells, add the word USA, and we'll copy that then out here to the right, and in these cells, Denmark, Control Enter. Okay, now what we want to do is we want to do a VLOOKUP here, equal VLOOKUP, go look up this value over in column B, and our lookup table, I'm going to click on the Denmark sheet and choose all of my data. Control Shift right arrow, Control Shift down arrow. I want to press F4 to put dollar signs in that address, comma, and right now I need a 2. All right, and if I was smart, I would have put a 2 up in row 1 so that way I could copy it over. I wasn't smart, so instead of typing a 2 here, I'm going to ask for the column of B1. Column B1, and then finally, comma, false, saying we want an exact match, no close matches. And we'll press Enter. Good, except for what I really needed. I didn't need column 2, I needed column D, which would be 1, 2, that would be the third column. So let's come in here and change from column of B1, which is the second column, to column of C1. Now this is just, frankly, me being lazy. I should type the number 2 in there, and then the number 3, and then the number 4, and the number 5, and so on. But I use that little trick here for just a quick and dirty analysis. So that way I don't have to type those various values in. Let's see, Control V. Okay, what did I do? I missed the dollar sign here, dollar sign before the B. All right, looks like we're starting to get some good values. Yep, no NAs. All right, so that's a good thing. At this point, I would probably convert these formulas to values. Key V. That was Control C if you're in Excel 2010, and that little key there on the right hand side between the Alt and Control, the program key. Program key V, fastest way to convert those. Otherwise, of course, you could use Home, Copy, and then Paste values, whatever works for you. And there you go, something a bit more permanent. Now, you're still going to probably have to use Freeze Panes here so that way you can see each value close to each other. A little bit more permanent than using the method from yesterday, the compare side by side. You actually get those values on the same spreadsheet. Now, if you needed to do some calculations, like comparing deltas or something like that, you could pull that off with this method. So probably, in my opinion, a better way to go, more permanent, gets the numbers on the same worksheet, lets you do calculations. You could even sort those together. That'd be a topic for you. Well, thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.